He explored the ceaseless miracle of himself held in a leash, bound to her vague caprice. He studies her ways, he saw he may prevail even for an hour, and she work out his will. He makes of her his moment, passion's surf. To away she faints, she follows her creature's lead. For him she was made, lives only for his use. In the symbol figures the cosmic force, and in her living and inanimate signs, and in her complex tracery of events, he explored the serious miracle of himself, till the thousandfold enigma has been solved in the single light of an all-witnessing soul. This was a compact with his mighty mate, for love of her, and joined to her forever, to follow the course of time's eternity, amid magic dramas of her sudden moves, and the surprises of her masked idiom, and the vicissitudes of her vast caprice. In this process of the cosmic working, there is a dual aspect. There is presence and there is power. There is being and there is consciousness force. There is self and nature. There is Purusha and Prakriti. Functionally, there is a division of job between the two, between the presence and the power. This division of jobs turns into a kind of separation when they come down into the cosmic field, as if they living independent of each other. They become he and she. He, the giver of sanction and witness being, and she, the executive dynamism to accomplish things in the process of evolving time. The two who are essentially one become the might and the right in things. He is the giver of the consent. Without that consent, she cannot start any action. He is the detached witness of all her movements, and he himself gets driven by her sweet and dreadful force. His fate is now sealed in her actions. He is governed by her modes and manners. She builds a cosmic empire, and in it he obeys her laws. A grand submission makes him docile to her. He does it out of his own free will, not out of any compulsion, but out of his own free will. He lends himself to her, that thus unhindered she may work upon the material nature. Her concern is to make the material nature an instrument of the soul, an instrument of the soul and the spirit. Thus the work goes on, with he as a support and she the activity. It is because of her long toil and labor that there is a possibility of a greater plan getting realized here. But what is her concern? What is the plan she intends to execute? It is to make us the sons of God. That is the plan. To make us the sons of God. If we are the sons of God, then we must have to become as He is, the human grown divine. We, the human, must grow divine. It is towards this is a tireless endeavor. But in the meanwhile, through her, He explored the ceaseless miracle of Himself. This is the unwritten agreement. This is the understanding between the two. This is the deal. This is the compact between He and she, between nature and soul, between the presence and the power. But this compact is for a purpose. The purpose is eventually to build a house here for the dwelling of the divine, to build a house here that divine may come and stay here. That is the purpose. And it is toward this purpose is the compact is prepared, is being executed. There has to be the body of flame and light to hold truth and joy and beauty. There has to be the multiplicity of existence in the greatness and glory of the Spirit.